Hey, welcome to another episode of Guitar Love. This is a video series where I pull out an instrument I've made over the last few years, check how it's holding up, dust it off, see how it looks, plays, and sounds. And this time around, it is, wow, the Prince Cymbal electric guitar. Wow, that is so cool. If you follow me on my Facebook page, you might recall that I made this guitar 14 months ago. And wow, I still think it's holding up absolutely amazingly. Oh wow, that is such a cool design. This is a replica of Prince's cymbal guitar, and he had this guitar made along with a bunch of other really cool guitars. This cymbal is supposed to represent a combination of the gender symbols for man and woman, and was intended to represent a merging of opposites and a new beginning. That was Prince's philosophy, and he actually adapted this symbol as his stage name until 2000, when he started using Prince again, but very cool indeed. This guitar's got a lot of great features. It's got the wraparound bridge, it's got an EMG 81 in the bridge position, and the neck pickup is a very hot dual, a single coil, very cool, volume and a tone, three-way selector switch, oh yeah. And wow, I remember when I made this guitar, see if I can get the camera to focus in on the Raglan logo on the pickguard. Very cool, very interesting build. I had so much fun making this guitar. I remember I didn't use 2K clear coat on these guitars because this is prior to me using clear coats, but I still think the color is very vibrant, very cool, gives it like that whole organic look. It plays and sounds absolutely amazing here. Completely reach all the highest frets with ease. It's a complete shred neck, as all of them are. Wow, sounds absolutely amazing. And if you're familiar with Prince and the Revolution, you know that Prince was actually a very good guitar player. He was really kind of not known for his lead playing, but he was just an outstanding lead guitar player. Some of his lead solos have so much taste and feel, and I figured it'd be very appropriate to cover a song from Prince and the Revolution in the Purple Rain era, do the song Let's Go Crazy. So very cool. And then after I'm showing you how great this guitar sounds and plays, I'll show you some real up close views of this very killer guitar. But until then, what do you think of this? Hey, welcome to another episode of Guitar Love. This is a video series where I pull out an instrument that I've made over the last few years, check how it's holding up, dust it off, see how it looks, plays, and sounds. And this time around, wow, it is the Prince Cymbal electric guitar. Very cool indeed. If you follow me over on my Facebook page, you may recall that I made this guitar 14 months ago. And I think it's still holding up absolutely amazing. It's got some really great features. First off being the very unique shape. This is a replica of Prince, his cymbal electric guitar. You can probably Google it online and find the original guitar. Very cool indeed. I had seen that guitar and I thought, you know, that'd be really cool to kind of reproduce that guitar and see if I can make my own version of it, which I think the results are just really cool indeed. guitar's got some really great features. It's got the wraparound tailpiece. It's got the EMG 81 in the bridge position. In the neck position, it's got a really hot, awesome, warm sounding dual humbucker. It's a humbucker, but it's in the single configuration. It's got the volume and the tone, three-way selector switch. Very cool indeed. Input jack. So, yeah. Very cool fretboard. 22 frets. Very cool headstock. This symbol is actually a cross between the male and female gender symbols, and it's a combination of the two. And it's bringing together of opposites. That's what Prince's philosophy was. And actually, Prince changed his name to this symbol in 1993 as a kind of a protest to Warner Brothers Records. But then he, you know, he changed it back in the 90s. But yeah, if you'd like to research about that, that's pretty cool too. But yeah, this guitar still sounds and plays absolutely amazing. Check it out. Wow. Complete shred neck, so. Very cool. Prince, in general, wasn't known as a lead guitarist, but his lead guitar skills were just absolutely incredible. He, some of the leads that he played on his album, if you go back and listen to his catalog, I mean, he's got such taste and such feel, and he articulates the notes so perfectly. Kind of reminds me of, like, Jimi Hendrix meets Steve Vai. I mean, he really could play really well, and so it kind of inspired me to play guitar way back in the day. And originally my thought was to do a cover of his song Let's Go Crazy. Prince, Let's Go Crazy, Prince and the Revolution off of the Purple Rain album, which actually the first time that this is the second go round of this video. I made a video where I covered his song Let's Go Crazy, and I think it turned out really, really cool. But when I uploaded it to YouTube, because of Prince's Foundation, and Prince is notorious for not allowing his music to be used without, you know, even he wouldn't even give permission. He was just really not a big fan of his songs being used in a way that wasn't, you know, by his doing. So yeah, the video was blocked worldwide, which I kind of, you know, knew that could happen, because I had been familiar with recording Prince's songs in the past. I actually did a version of Purple Rain on my other YouTube channel, just as, you know, a cover, and that was taken down. And no matter what you do, he just, if you have any of his music in your videos, it's just not, you know, he won't allow that, they won't allow it. But anyway, so I figured for a cover around this time around, we'll do some Metallica, The Prince, you know, kind of for The Prince. And so what do you think of this? We'll be right back. Wow, very cool indeed. Metallica, the Prince. All right, I just wanted to give you a brief demonstration of how great this guitar sounds and plays. Whew, that'll wake you up in the morning. Let me show you some really kind of up close views of this very cool guitar. Yeah. And very cool indeed. And if you follow me over on my Facebook, you'll know that originally I did a cover of Prince's Let's Go Crazy, but that video was blocked on YouTube for copyright because the Prince Foundation, the people that run his estate, or even when he was alive, he was notorious for people using his music in anything really, video without explicit permission. He was very much against that, which, you know, that was his right, and it still carries on to this day. I did the video and it turned out pretty cool, but it was blocked, so I redid it with Metallica's Prince, the Prince, which that song is definitely intense and very cool. I love that. Well, I've been a fan of Metallica for most of, you know, as long as back as I could remember. But yeah, this guitar turned out very cool indeed. And it kind of like, if you were to like playing a video game, it would be like a spear. Could you imagine like a spear, a dagger coming at you like that? Or like if it was like some sort of weird spaceship, like, you know, get a blue screen and get this guitar in space and kind of, you know, kind of like the new starship, Star Trek Enterprise. It would be the shape of this very cool guitar. Yeah. All right. Thanks again for watching. And if you're watching this over on my YouTube channel, Ryan Pan's Guitar Love, please like, subscribe, and please leave a comment. Tell me what you think of these radical guitars that I build. I very much enjoy it, and I do appreciate everyone that's here watching. Very cool. Yeah. And if you've seen other recreations of this particular guitar, his symbol, a lot of times they'll put the Prince symbol on the frets or on the side of the frets, on the fret for the fret markers. I chose not to do that. I kind of like it looking, the sleek look of it looking, just no fret markers at all. So that was actually pretty cool. And the headstock there, that was a really cool process of creating that whole shape and the countersunk tuning peg tops. So I'll definitely leave a link in description of how I created this guitar from start to finish if you'd like to go have a look at that. Very cool process indeed. My sister's a really big Kiss fan, or not Kiss fan, but Prince fan. So I remember when I was creating these guitars, I was kind of thinking of her. So if Jennifer happens to be watching, a shout out to you, Jennifer. Very cool. Yeah, that really cool angles. I mean, with the shape of the guitar, not to get kind of like too abstract, but that is very cool. If you had that effect on there, wow, kind of like the whole 3D. Could you imagine, like, you know, back in the day, like, you know, times like knights and castles and everything like that, and you brought out one of these, and almost like a weapon, they kind of look at you like, what the hell is that thing? All right. Thanks again for watching another episode. Thanks for bearing with me with my crazy antics. Very cool. And we will see you on the next episode. Yeah, it's always cool to get some really cool angles. Angles people don't really show in videos that I always thought was kind of neat to see the guitar from a certain point of view. Very cool indeed. Yeah, that fin is something else, huh? Very cool guitar. Alright, rock on, my friends. Very cool indeed. Wow, that was just great. And I love that song. Wow. I just want to give you a brief demonstration of how great this guitar sounds and plays. Wow. Very cool indeed. Yeah. That Prince, he is very, very good artist. Very great solo player. Very cool. Just wanted to show you some up close views of this very cool guitar. And wow, I remember this guitar, like I said earlier, being so much fun to make. Let me show you the back. And I was making it, I was singing in my head constantly all the songs from Purple Rain. And I got the neck pocket dialed in perfectly on this one as well. Sorry for my sad attempt at Prince's Let's Go Crazy song. Yeah, those leads are very, very good. And I like the way that it turned out. Very cool indeed. I did the volute. Custom shape on the headstock. I love that, all the little hearts and all the little indentation parts. Very cool indeed. Very awesome guitar. And it's well balanced too. I mean, you're surprised for such a very odd shape. I mean, print symbol. And I learned so much from making this guitar. And it's such a privilege to be able to go back and look at guitars that I made so long ago. And I did get a lot better with the edges and making the bits more perfect. But very cool indeed. Thanks again for watching another episode of Guitar Love. Please show this video some love, give it a like, leave me a comment. If you're not subscribed on my YouTube channel, please subscribe to see some really cool stuff. And you should go back through the episodes and look at the guitars that I've already showcased that I've made. Very cool indeed. Yeah, and see, that was really cool. And I'll leave a link in the description how I made this guitar from start to finish. In the pinned comments on YouTube and in the description as well. So have a look there. Please follow me on Facebook if you'd like, my Facebook page. If you ever have any questions or anything you'd like to know about the process and how I do what I do, just leave me a comment. And I appreciate everyone that's here, everybody watches these videos. And if you made it to the end, thumbs up to you, great. I so much appreciate it. And these videos aren't monetized. I don't make anything. It's just showing my art, having pride in what I do. And I don't have necessarily a guitar business. I mean, I have sold one or two here and there, a few here and there. And if I get a request, I'll definitely make one for someone that has a request. But all these guitars that I've showcased on this series of Guitar Love are pretty much for my own personal music, personal amusement, and for my own personal collection. So I've gathered quite a few guitars and I have so many more to share, so stay tuned. And we will see you on the next episode. Very cool. Try to give you some very unique angles you won't see anywhere else. That is cool. Could you imagine like a video game that's coming at you like a dagger? Like, whoa. Like, whoa, that's cool. Like, whoa, or if this, this guitar was some sort of like spaceship. I'm sorry. I'm a little crazy. Alright. Thanks again for watching. And rock on, my friends.